Astronomers have witnessed a stellar eruption on the red supergiant star Betelgeuse, the largest star in the Orion constellation, the likes of which have never been seen before. Betelgeuse, a red supergiant star on Orion's right upper shoulder, initially gained widespread attention in late 2019, when its brightness suddenly dimmed. In 2020, the supergiant's fading was still in full swing. But what happened now? Has it reached its end? What will happen now? Are we safe? Want to know more about it? Don't worry, the Future Space got your back. Betelgeuse, a massive red supergiant star, has reached the end of its lifespan, at least in terms of cosmic timescales, but the enormous fireball is going out with a bang and isn't leaving quietly. In 2019, astronomers were able to determine, with the assistance of NASA's Hubble Space Telescope and other observatories, that the senior star had, in fact, expelled a portion of its surface. Andrea Dupree, who works at the Harvard and Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics, made these comments in a statement. "We've never before seen a massive mass ejection of the surface of a star," she said. "We are left with something going on that we don't quite comprehend. It's a completely new phenomenon that we can witness directly and resolve surface details with Hubble. We're watching the evolution of stars in real time," said the astronomer. "We're observing stellar evolution in real time." An article that was published in the Astrophysical Journal by Dupree as the first author details the explosion and the fallout it has caused. The bloated late-stage star has a mind-boggling diameter of about 1 billion miles, which indicates that if you were to replace our sun with Betelgeuse, the star would extend all the way out to Jupiter's orbit. Betelgeuse is only 10 million years old, yet there is a chance that it will go extinct in a supernova explosion within the next 100,000 years. In comparison, our sun is approximately 5 billion years old, making it a middle-aged star. Betelgeuse, on the other hand, is only 10 million years old. The red supergiant star Betelgeuse underwent a titanic mass ejection of a substantial section of its visible surface, and this illustration tracks the changes that occurred in the star's brightness as a result of this event. The material that was able to flee the star eventually froze and formed a cloud of dust, which temporarily made the star appear less bright as viewed from Earth. The researchers refer to the event that occurred in 2019 as a surface mass ejection, or SME for short. This phenomenon is somewhat comparable to the coronal mass ejections that we see erupt from the outer atmosphere of our own sun, which frequently cause vivid auroras and disruptions in radio transmissions on Earth. On the other hand, the eruption from Betelgeuse expelled almost 400 billion times more mass than a typical CME does. A dust cloud formed around the star as a result of a chunk of its surface being blown off, and the star was also left with a sizable cool patch on its surface. Because of this, Betelgeuse became noticeably dimmer, to the point where even inexperienced astronomers were able to detect the shift. For a considerable amount of time in 2019 and 2020, people discussed the possibility that the dimming was an indication that the star was about to go supernova. It is now more evident that the dimming was actually evidence of a smaller explosion that had previously occurred, and Dupree emphasized that although dramatic, sending a part of itself into space does not suggest that the end of Betelgeuse is near. In point of fact, the star is making a gradual recovery after the explosion. According to Dupree, Betelgeuse is continuing to do some very weird things right now. The interior is sort of bouncing. Even in the middle of the day, people on Earth will be able to see the remains of Betelgeuse after it ultimately succeeds in destroying itself totally. The next step for astronomers will be to continue analyzing the data that was produced by the explosion in order to acquire a clearer picture of what took place. Researchers may even attempt to use the James Webb Space Telescope that is operated by NASA in order to take pictures of the piece of the supergiant star that was ejected into space and is now moving through the cosmos. Are there any stars that can go supernova? There is no other star that we are aware of that is likely to go supernova any sooner than Betelgeuse. The so-called Type 1a supernovae, which can occur when two stars orbit one another and one of the stars is a tiny dim white dwarf, are the exception, he continues. These supernovae are rare. When one star expands toward the end of its life, it can drop material onto the white dwarf, and in some situations, its mass can grow until it comes close to around 1.4 times the mass of the Sun. Even though astronomers presently know very little about the white dwarfs in the Milky Way, an explosion is still possible in these circumstances. However, the Gaia satellite from the European Space Agency is working to change this. Betelgeuse is still the best option for viewing a supernova, certainly in terms of a brilliant star that can be seen by anyone who looks up and sees it. Orion is quite a prominent constellation, and anyone who is familiar with it may glance at his left shoulder and observe that the star is noticeably weaker than it used to be. The star used to be much brighter than it is now. But before it, the nova was supposed to happen in 2083. Even if it was anticipated that Betelgeuse will go supernova in 100,000 years, it has possibly gone exploded sooner. However, a number of scientists now believe that there is a star located considerably closer that is capable of going nova. New research suggests that a star known as V Sagittae, which is located 7,800 light-years away in the tiny constellation of Sagitta just below Cygnus, in the famous asterism of stars known as the Summer Triangle, could blow up around the year 2083. This star is barely visible even in medium-sized telescopes. Even though it won't be as impressive as Betelgeuse going supernova, when V Sagittae explodes, it could become as bright as Sirius, which is currently the brightest star in the night sky. It will also momentarily take the title of the star in the Milky Way galaxy with the highest luminosity. According to Professor Emeritus Bradley E. Schaefer of the LSU Department of Physics and Astronomy, about the year 2083, its accretion rate will rise catastrophically, dumping mass at extraordinarily high rates onto the white dwarf, with this material burning away. This prediction was made by Professor Schaefer. In the closing days of this death spiral, all of the mass from the companion star will descend onto the white dwarf. This will create a supermassive wind from the merging star, which will look as brilliant as Sirius, and potentially even as bright as Venus. What is the kill zone for supernovas? Are we safe? Yes, we are safe. There is no reason to worry about any star, certainly not any nearby star, going supernova and hurting us in any way. Who agrees that the kill zone for a supernova is somewhere in the region of 40 to 50 light years? The distance between our planet and Betelgeuse is around 650 light years. If Betelgeuse were to go off, it would become roughly as bright as the full moon. While this may have the potential to affect the circadian cycles of some animals in a small way, it would not lead to the extinction of any species. Because there is no evidence to suggest that a supernova was the cause of any of the known mass extinctions in the history of life on Earth, it is evident that this type of event does not occur very frequently. On the other hand, he does mention that there is a possibility of the danger posed by the high-energy X-rays and gamma rays emitted by a supernova and their interaction with the atmosphere on Earth. One of the key concerns is that the ozone layer gets destroyed, which would result in a significantly increased amount of UV radiation from the sun penetrating the atmosphere. This has the potential to wreak havoc, resulting in the death of plankton in the ocean and having an effect on the entire food chain. That's all for today. Hope you liked our video. So, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more of our incredible videos. Click on the like button and share our video with your families and friends. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.